Greatest Nigeria youth.
Great.
Greatest Nigeria youth.
Great.
You are sounding like Nigeria elders. Of the greatest Nigeria youth.
Great.
Greatest Gogo.
Gogo.
Alright. You are welcome today to the palace of Kabowe Kingdom, which is the headquarters of Kabowe Kingdom and Patani Town. Is also the headquarters of Patani local government. I can see some youth leaders here present, Fahawake and other members here present, and even Patani community youth executive, the CLO, and his caucus. You are all welcome today. I must say, I'm very much impressed with this drive you are on this morning. Marking the International Day of Drug Abuse in Patani local government. I think for the few times I've been resident here in Patani, I have been here in Patani before leaving for school and coming back again as well. I think we've had some and recorded some level of drug abuse in town by the young ones, which I frowned at initially, and when the youth body came up, the Patani youth body and also the National Council of Youth President, the Patani chapter, came up with this idea, I embraced it. It was a welcome idea, and I encouraged him to do more about it, to create awareness for our youth to know about the dangers in abusing drugs, because when you engage in taking drugs, you destroy your future. And I am also used by blood. And if this generation is destroyed, that means when we are all aged and elderly, then there will be nothing to write home about this generation. So the fight against drugs is something we should all put our mind to. It's not just by coming out today to dance and sing and tell people, not do drugs, then later in the evening, you go back and take codeine and tramadol. It's a thing that we all individually have to work out and fight, not just by saying it, but putting our best to seeing that we stop abusing drugs. There is nothing wrong in maybe on a normal day, codeine is for cough, but now people abuse it and use it for all manner. I was told just 2 days back, of somebody that took tramadol, not in Patani though, but he was walking into tramadol, he jumped into the river, and that was his end. And for a young man of 22 years to end his life like that, what hope does the elders and the parents have for their upcoming children? I am very happy that the coffers are also involved in this. I'm happy that our youth in town here are fully involved in this. Please, those ones that are teaching, and even the students here, when you get back, talk to your friends, talk to your brother, let them stay off drugs, because it destroys the future. It destroys this generation. And if before now drugs were not used and Nigeria is like this because of maybe the way the elders didn't really have education and all, we should better this nation rather than destroy ourselves. Before now, when the elders were young, they were not using drugs, but we are still using drugs, but we are still where we are now. So just imagine with the level of education these youths have now and without drugs, where we will be in the next future, in the next 20, 30 years from now, where will Nigeria be? But when we destroy ourselves by taking all manner of drugs, getting high unnecessarily and destroying ourselves, abusing young ones after abusing